Jesus is God and that he is Lord. Because he is God and because he is Lord, one day we're all going to stand before him and give an account of our lives by how we lived our lives. So that's the only reason why we're here. We want you to know the truth. For the word of God says that the truth can set you free. What is it that you need to be set free from? You need to be set free from the bondage of your sin. That's the thing, we need to be set free from the bondage of our sin. And the only way you're going to be set free is if God sets you free. And that's through the preaching of the gospel. So we come to preach the gospel, that which is the good news, so you'll know how you're going to stand before this holy, righteous, and just God. We're here because we care about you. We care about your soul. Where your soul will spend eternity. For one day, the life that you're living now will come to an end. See, that's the thing. Everybody thinks that they're okay as they walk around doing whatever it is that you think is right in your own eyes. For the word of God declares there's a way that seems right to a man, but its end leads to death. See, this man's been sitting here with this umbrella. He's been dancing around thinking that he's okay. He's going to be okay. He's probably even said in his heart, if there is a God, why don't you strike me dead? You see, the thing is, God moves in his terms. We were made by him. We were made by him. He does things on his terms. See, the thing is, he's going to call us to stand before him on his terms. See, the thing is, he's going to call us to stand before him on his terms. Not us. It's not up to us. See, the thing is, we believe that the world revolves around us. But ladies and gentlemen, the bad news is this, is that it does not revolve around you. The world doesn't revolve around you, and you act the way that you do because there is no fear of God before your eyes. The God that's created you in his image, you're going to stand before him and give an account. You're going to give an account to the creator of the heavens and the earth, the one that spoke you into existence. You see, we've been talking about every single person out here, every person that has air in their lungs. We all need a Savior because we've all sinned against the holy, righteous, and just God. And you see, ladies and gentlemen, God demonstrates his mercy to us each and every day. He allows you to take another breath. He's allowed these people to sit out here and earn a living. This very God that created you in his image, he has allowed you to earn a living. Do you not realize this? By God's mercy and by his grace, by his very grace, he allows you to hear the message of the gospel. See, by God's very grace, he allows you to hear the message of the gospel. You see, there are many people around this world who will never, ever get to hear the message of life. And yet, this man right here will mock God. He mocks God. He mocks God. And you see, the thing is, many of you will also mock God too. You'll even take his name and you'll use it as a curse word. And some of you will even say that you belong to God, but yet you hate him. And you even hate his son. And you hate to hear his name mentioned. You'll cover your ears and you'll run away and you'll do a little dance and you'll say, oh, why doesn't Jesus pay my rent? Is that all you care about? About your rent? Did you ever think about where you're going to spend eternity? Because one day you're going to pass from this life into the next. And you know what? You will not get to hear this message again. The Bible says that you'll weep. You'll weep for all of eternity. You will. You'll be tormented forever in eternal darkness, in eternal fire, because of your hatred of God, thinking that the world revolves around you. It's blasphemy. He should strike you dead. Sir, God should strike you dead right now. But because of his mercy, by his very mercy, he allowed you to take another breath. That goes for each and every one of us. Each and every one of us. Goes for each and every one of us. God allows us to have another breath. even when we mock him, when we mock the preaching of the gospel. God shows you mercy, that which you don't deserve.